Hello everyone and welcome to the Legend of Zelda Four Swords Adventures walkthrough. I haven't played this game in a while. As a matter of fact, I'll just take a look at the date on this game. Yeah, this was made in 2004. I beat the game when it came out, but only once. Yes, only once. So I haven't played this game since then. Which means I pretty much barely remember anything about this game other than the fact that it's like one-player sort of teamwork kind of game. You can use your Game Boy Advance along with this, but I'm gonna be playing this for you guys so you guys can see what it'll be on the screen. Well, I'll get to that when I get to the gameplay, but this game can be played with multiple players, but you need Game Boy Advances and Game Boy Advance to GameCube link cables. So, enough with the intro, let's just get to this walkthrough. Long ago, in the kingdom of Hyrule, a wind sorcerer named Vati appeared, and why am I reading this? I don't know. So, I guess I should explain it while this intro's going. If you have a Game Boy Advance, you can connect it to the GameCube, and whenever you go inside, like, a building or inside a cave, you can look on your Game Boy Advance screen, and you'll see that you actually went inside your Game Boy Advance rather than inside the in-game cave. Which is kind of like a neat little aspect, and since four players can play this game using that method with the Game Boy Advance and link cables, this game is a great multiplayer game, but I've never played it multiplayer. So, I mean, there's like a lot of equipment that you need. You need four Game Boy Advances, which everyone should provide, but not everyone has the Game Boy Advance to GameCube link cable, and way back then, they were like $15 a piece or something like that. So, that didn't really catch on, obviously. Link, can you hear my voice? No, it's text! You can't hear text! Unless you hear... I should also mention that this game takes, like, sound effects and graphics from a lot of different Zelda games. Like, you're gonna notice a lot of references just with the graphics to, like, Zelda Wind Waker, Link to the Past, and then there's sound effects from Ocarina of Time, and there's also graphics from the Minish Cap too, Zelda Minish Cap. So this game is like a hybrid of all the Zeldas combined. Well, okay, not all the Zeldas, just all the like really polished Zeldas, so to speak. Not like the first two and stuff like that. You get what I mean. So anyway, I must hurry to Hyrule Castle. Because something is going down and there's lightning flashes and oh my god, it's black. Luckily that's not a loading screen. Oh, it's Hyrule Castle and it's raining. Hey there, Zelda, how's it going? Oh, I'm happy I came too, but I don't know why exactly I came. The six maidens who guard the... Oh my god, they're gathered. Why are they at the castle? Shouldn't they be at their different dungeons and guarding them and stuff like that? I see, like, this is Link to the Past graphics combined with the sprites of Minish Cap. You can see that right there. So I guess I gotta go that way. This is still automatically controlled. I'm not doing anything right now. Whoa, spooky area. Oh, and the six maidens guard the portal full of... I said power. Portal to the Four Sword Sanctuary. I will keep it safe. Oh, I hope you keep that seal strong, Zelda. We must keep this seal away for this world's safety. Do a prayer. Glowy. Whoa. Don't ask me why the camera can handle this scene of all scenes nicely. I have no idea why. It must be like the amount of darkness to light ratio, like on the camera screen. Like I've always joked around with how cameras handle the dark scenes, but this handles it pretty well, except for the text. Whoa, what the heck happened? Oh my god, it's Shadow Link! What are you doing here? Oh my goodness, we have to stop him! Wait, what? How are you doing this? You just trapped all the most powerful maidens in the lands with just one shot? Amazing! I guess those maidens aren't very strong after all. Oh no, they're trapped in darkness and they're going into the darkness and we gotta save them! Kill Shadow Link, Link! Kill your doppelganger! Go into the light! Woo! There's Shadow Link. And he's going after something. Oh my god, it's a sword! Could this be the fabled Four Sword of Legends? It is the Four Sword Sanctuary, so it has to be. Run for it, Shadow Link! You must get to the sword before Link does! Aha! Ah! Aha! Ow! Aha! Okay, I'll just grab the sword. Grab it with the R button. Oh wait, maybe I'm supposed to grab it from the front. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's the R button to grab it, though. And, yeah, I will draw forth the sword. I don't care about the consequences. The consequences will never be the same anyway! Yeah, I just had to make that reference. Aha! It's 4-1 now. You better run! Better run, sucker. What the heck did I just do? Oh my god, I have unleashed a tornado upon this world in a dark light that seems to be sprung forth from within the pedestal the sword rests in. Oh my god, it's Vati! Vati and Shadow Link teamed up at last! What have I done? Why did I draw that sword? I mean, I could have just dealt with Shadow Link. Link, you have accepted the destiny of the hero. You probably can't read this, so I'll read it to you. Princess Zelda and the six maidens have been taken by dark forces. I was going to say darkness. But there's a space in there somewhere, as you can see. However, Vati's magic has robbed the four swords of its power to vanquish darkness. Wait, how did he rob the four sword of its power? The four sword kind of, you know, it was sealing him in. Whatever, don't question the game. So I thought the sword was more powerful than Vati if it sealed him in. But gather force gems wherever they lie and rescue the maidens and Princess Zelda! I shall do that, mysterious floating text. And so the game starts at Lake Hyla. Level 1, Whereabouts of the Wind. Woo! Oh no, I am knocked out! Link, you must awaken, Link! Actually, I think that's the dang owl. Kiapora Gayabora or something like that, his name is. Kiapora Gayabora. I was never sure of how his name is pronounced. Anyway, yes, I am concerned about getting... I mean, finding Vati, but I must always think before I act, for the six Shrine Maidens and Princess Zelda will die if I don't think before I act, because I won't make it to them, and I gotta stop Shadow Link along with Vati, and it's just chaos in Hyrule, and that's basically the plot of the game. So anyway, let's get this game started, and you see these guys, yeah, they're all passed out. They're my doppelganger clone. Well, not doppelganger clones. They're my clones. It's split me. There's different guys, and they'll call them to you. All you have to do is press the X button. Well, I mean, excuse me, the Y button. Woo! And now when you press the X button again, you can change formation. Like, if you choose this one, you'll go into a diamond, and you control them all simultaneously. And choose this one, you'll get into a nice line, and can I cut this? No, I can't cut this. And go to this one, you got a vertical line. You can cut, by the way, depending on your formation, you can cut through things and get through things easier than with other formations. And you can also change them with the C-stick. The last formation is a square. This is probably the most versatile of ones, especially if you're in combat, because if you spin the control stick and then swing the sword, you can do a little, like a rotational swing, the spin attack. If you press the C button up, wait, I'll just go back into normal mode there. If you press C button up, you'll go to a square. I shouldn't say C button, the C stick up. Go to the right, you'll go into the horizontal formation. Down is vertical, and to the left is a diamond. That's a lot faster than pressing the Y button each time. If you press the X button, you'll be able to control each of these links individually by cycling through them like this. And when you press the Y button, you can call them all towards you at the same time. That's the way to control each link individually, and that's the only way to do it. Now, this is what I mean about being able to go through things a lot faster. Go into like horizontal formation, and you'll just be able to chop through this grass without any trouble. Now, the object of each stage is to collect as many force gems as you need. Like, this stage needs about 2,000 force gems. I already collected a bunch of them. There's 1988 remaining there, if you didn't see that next to the sword. Yeah, that number above the sword is the number that you need to get. And why did I find that number so funny? It's because it's my birthday. Yeah, I'm 22 years old. So, yeah. That's basically the idea. And you must gather the four at the arrows to proceed. What are you talking about there, mysterious text? Well, anyway, so I gotta go meet up with those guys in there for a little tutorial. But I already kind of explained that, but I'll just go through it anyway. Whoa! Yeah, this is what I was talking about, that if you have a Game Boy Advance plugged into the GameCube, you can have the screen come, like, towards you, like, you know, this screen will be on the Game Boy Advance, is what I'm saying. But instead, it's on the GameCube screen. And you can talk to people with the A button. I've never seen you lads in these parts before. It's twins! It's four twins that... Oh, whatever. I'm spending my retirement teaching about my grandkids all about formations! Oh, you're gonna teach me about formations, too? Okay, you might as well teach me about it. Let's go into the backyard! Now I gotta stand in the left square. The only stage that I've played just to get the hang of this game again was this first stage. So I already know what to do and stuff like that. And oh no, gotta explain. No, I already explained this, Gramps. You really don't have to. Oh, I guess you can press the L button too. So if you don't want to press the Y button to change formations, you can do the L button too. So let's press the L button. Whoa, box formation! And Y formation. I'll just use a C stick for that. And long formation. Woo! Now one more to go. It's probably the... Yep, it's the cross. Oh, diamond power! And force gems for all my hard work. Thank you. I'm going to need them to power up the sword. At the end of the stage, there's a barrier that you have to break through with your sword. And that is what you need these force gems for. If you don't collect as many force gems as you need... you won't be able to get through that barrier. Oh, I should also mention here, when you got this screen up here, you can press the Z button to close it, but I have no idea why you would want to do that. Because you can't see what the heck you're doing. So, just keep the screen up. So, yeah, you can move when it's like that, but, nah, forget about it. Just leave the screen up at all times. Okay, you see this button? You see this button? Press it. Yay, force gems for the win! They are the star bits of the Zelda world. Or at least this Zelda, I should say. And go into horizontal formation and push this rock into the water. You can also check this sign here. Oh yeah, if you hold the B button, you can charge up a spin attack and that'll zoom out the camera. Woo! That's another way of doing the spin attack rather than rotating the control stick and then doing a spin. That's a classic Zelda. I just didn't really think about it because it's like second nature. Let's go inside this cave. Woo! The camera can handle the darkness because there's brightness around it. My plan is working. Yes. See, this is why I carefully choose each game before I play it. And I got the boomerang. Woo! I can press the A button to send it winging away. This is basically how you get items in this game. And when you leave the area, you leave all your power-ups and all your items and whatever you had in the stage behind. So this is like, it's like a stage-based, maybe even arcade-style Zelda. But anyway, there's your boomerang! Yay! You can use it to collect force gems across the water. Oh yeah, we are equipped to kill, baby!